tuyimirireko.
Before the match kicked off, players and officials of both Cranes and the Sudan team paid tribute to a fallen netball player, Harriet Apako, by observing a minute of silence before the kickoff. The match then started with Uganda attacking Sudan. However, many chances were put to waste. Frank Kalanda headed a Caesar Okuti cross, but the Sudan keeper made a save. Muzamil Mutiaba was close to pick on a rebound, enabling Kalanda to tap home the first goal. Still in the first half, the Cranes captain Farouk Miya scored with a sole effort to extend Uganda's lead. Cranes came back in the second half strong, but were dealt a blow when centre-back Hassan Waswadazo brought down a Sudanese striker in box. Dazo was given a straight red card and a penalty awarded against the Cranes, but goalkeeper James Alisa was the hero when he saved the penalty. The Cranes will need to go to Sudan and defend their lead next Saturday if they are to progress to the final CHAN tournament that will be held in Rwanda next year.
What I expect is a win. We shall not draw. We shall just go and beat them. If they continue playing like this, we shall just beat them. That is what I assure all the fans of Uganda Cranes.
If we are going to defend this result in Khartoum, it's the same like calling the devil to come to your house. Therefore, we need to go there with a balanced approach in order to score the goal and to kill off the game. It will be very hard, but we have whole week to work in front of us.